अथ इदमस्मिन् ब्रह्मपुरे दहरं पुण्डरीकं वेश्म दहरो अस्मिन्नन्तराकाशस् तस्मिन्निद्यन्तस्तदन्वेष्टव्यं तद्वाव विजिज्ञासितव्यमिति। अथ सम टीचर इन फ्रंट ऑफ हिज डिसाइपल्स हैविंग गिवन ऑल द रेस्ट ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शंस रिगार्डिंग अपर विद्या डिफरेंट मैटर्स As a final instruction, he spells out this then. Then means after having heard of the rest of the scriptures. Now I want to tell a special thing. Paravidya, for that it begins then. Yadidam asmin brahmapure. Asmin brahmapure. In this city of Brahman, the gross and subtle body. This is the city of Brahman. Yadidam daharam, that which is this, a small, daharam means small, pundarikam, lotus like lotus, veshma, a dwelling like dwelling, a house like a house. Their small house and looks like a lotus. There's a heart. In this body, heart is the place. Asmin antaha dharo akasha. Even inside that means inside that hriday kamalam, the heart lotus, there's another small space. In this big body, heart is small. Inside that, still smaller than the heart, there is small space. Inside that space, you see now again. Tasmin yadantaha. Inside that smallest space also, yad bhavati tadanveshtavya. That which is existing there, that has to be known. Tadvava vijigyasitavyam. That indeed has to be inquired about, realized about for liberation. Is what he announced. And sees now the disciples, if they're interested, they will ask, and then I'll reply, otherwise, let them go home with whatever they have learned. Atha anantaram. Atha means anantaram. After that, then, yadidam vakshamanam. That which is this, which is going to be spoken of. Daharam, alpam, small, pundarikam, pundarika sadrisham. Looks as if like a lotus. Veshma eva veshma, which is like a dwelling, a house like a house, small place where this Brahma resides. Because that's why it's called as a dwelling, a house. Veshma. Why is being called as Veshma? Dwarapalaadimatvat. Because of its possession of gatekeepers, etc. And about these gatekeepers, is already discussed in Gayatri Vidya. In Chandra Prashad, it has already been discussed in Gayatri Vidya. It is in 313.1. Edasya hridayasya pancha deva sushaya. There are five doors, it was said over there. One doorkeeper is Vishnu, one doorkeeper is Sun, one doorkeeper is Chandra and all. It is said over there in 313.1, third chapter, 13th part, and the first mantra. In that whole part, this has been discussed. Asmin Brahmapure, within this city of Brahman, Brahmana Parasya Puram. What is that Brahman? The supreme thing. Of it is this city. Just like Raja Anega Pakriti Mad Yatha. पुरम तथा इदम अनेकेंद्र मनोबुद्धि स्वाम्यर्थ कार्य युक्तम इति ब्रह्मपुरम. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज ब्रह्मपुरम बिकॉज इट इज जस्ट लाइक अ किंग्स सिटी इन विच अ सिटी ऑफ अ किंग इज फुल ऑफ थिंग्स एंड ऑफिशियल्स. द ऑफिसर्स आर देयर, देयर वर्किंग, देयर मॉड लॉट थिंग्स आर देयर, पीपल आर देयर, थ्रू देम ही एंजॉयज थिंग्स. सिमिलरली इज हियर ऑल्सो. तथा इदम ब्रह्मपुरम, इदम दिस बॉडी विच इज द ब्रह्मपुरा, द सिटी ऑफ ब्रह्मन, सिमिलरली This city of Brahman, the supreme reality, is consisting of what? Is possessing of what? Manobuddhibihi. Indriya manobuddhibihi. Is possessing of organs, sense organs, mind, intellect, etc. And what for they are? So, swamirtha karivihi, which fulfill the needs of the master. Hence, it is called as Brahmapuram, the city of the supreme reality. And in this city there is a house. Just like many houses are in one city, here also there are many houses. The important house will be considering the king's palace. All are not palaces. Houses are many, but palace is one. Therefore, you do not say griham. He's knowingly using the word veshma, special dwelling. Griham is ordinary house. Special dwelling is palace. What is the palace of the king? It is the heart. Purecha veshma, rajyo yatha. And as the king has a special palace in his city, tatha similarly, tasmin brahmapure, in this city of the supreme reality, sharire. You see, Bhaskara is clear here. Brahmapure means sharire, the body. There is a small place, small palace. The palace is very small. Dharam, veshma, brahmana, upalabdhi adhishthamityartha. There is a small dwelling, that means it's a place of self-realization. It's a place where you are going to attain yourself, the Brahman. Brahmana upalabdhi adhishthanam. It is the adhishthanam, the place where you are going to experience or realize Brahman. That is the heart. This is the meaning of the statement. Yatha vishvahosalagrama. Just like is an example of the stone, special stone called a shalagrama, in which you see Vishnu. The upalabdhi sthanam of Vishnu is shalagrama. Asmini svavikara shunye dehe namarupa vyakaranaya pravishtam sadatyam brahma jivena atmana ittuktam. Ittuktam means it has been already been said. It has been already said before that this supreme reality, which is called as existence, Sadakyam Brahma, has entered Pravishtam, Asmin, in this body. For what? Svavikar. How is that first? Svavikara Shunge. In the form of an individual soul, Pravishtam, Jivena Atmana. In the form of an individual soul. Into this body, which is just like a sprout of its own products. Svavikara Shunge. For what purpose it is entered? Nam rupa vyakaranaya. For the manifestation of names and forms. So it's clear that it is Brahman only has entered into this heart, in this body, and is residing in the heart for the purpose of nam rupa vyakaranam, and in the form of jiva, as an individual soul, for manifesting names and forms. Therefore, this body is called as Brahmapuram, and the heart is called as the palace of Brahman. Tasmad asmin hrudaya pundarike. No, Bhashakar uses the word hrudaya. Asmin hrudaya pundarike veshmani upasurta karunair bahi vishay viraktair visheshado brahmacharya satya sadhanabhyam yuktair vakshamana gunavad dhyayamanair brahma upalabhyatiti prakaranartha. This is the meaning of the whole context, is it? What is the meaning of the whole context? Because it is so, therefore. Tasmat. Asmin hrudaya pundarike. In the dwelling, which is just like a lotus, this great heart. Veshmani. In this dwelling, which is looks like a lotus, that is heart. Upasangrita karunaihi. The supreme reality is experienced, is realized. Brahma upalabhyate. In the last it is done. See, first you take that. Brahma asmin veshmani brahma upalabhyate. In this dwelling, the palace, the heart of Brahman, the dwelling of Brahman, the palace of Brahman is the heart. Inside that, you will be experiencing, realizing the Brahman. But by whom? Those people who upasanghrita karanaihi बाह्य विषय विरक्त ही विशेषतो ब्रह्मचर्य सत्य साधनाभ्याम युक्त ही सच पीपल ओनली सी द कंडीशंस पुट वेरी डिफिकल्ट उपसंहृत करण ही सेस बाय दोज हु हैव विड्रॉन देयर सेंसेस फ्रॉम ऑल द ऑब्जेक्ट्स फ्रॉम ऑल टाइप्स ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट्स ऑफ ऑल द फाइव सेंस ऑर्गन्स एंड द मोटर ऑर्गन्स उपसंहृत करण ही बाह्य विषय विरक्त बाह्य विषय विरक्त ही एंड हु आर टोटली डिटैच्ड फ्रॉम ऑल द एक्सटर्नल थिंग्स एंड ऑल्सो पॉसेस दिस टू ग्रेट means of realization number 1 brahmacharya number 2 satyam brahmacharya satya sadhana abhyam yuktai and those who are endowed with these two great means of realization the celibacy and truthfulness for them and how not only by possessing these qualities is not enough you should be meditating in the heart on that quality to brahman with the qualities which are going to mentioned being mentioned later vakshamana gunavat brahman dhyayamani vakshamana guna the guna the aptaka satyakama and all will be stated later on which will be spoken of later with those qualities we have to meditate on that brahman in the heart whoever person with these qualities meditates on that Brahman, quality Brahman in the heart, is going to experience Brahman in the heart. This is the meaning of the context. Now it comes to the further part, Dharo Asminantra Akasha. Dharo, man Alpataro. Yes, Dharam, inside that Dharam, another Dhara. Dhara, Dhara, how it can be? It should be Alpataram. That is Alpam. Small, this should be smaller than that. Alpataro. Asmin dahare veshmani. In this dwelling, with this small dwelling, there is a smaller space than the dwelling. It's natural. The space within should be naturally smaller than the dwelling. That's why it says, veshmano alpatvat, tadantarvartino alpatratam veshmanaha. As and because the dwelling is small, therefore it's natural, the thing which is included within it is smaller than the Veshma, the palace, the place. Antarakasha. Akashakyam Brahma. Inside is the space. And that space is called, which is called by the word Akasha over here, is nothing else other than Brahman. Akashastalingat is a sutra in Brahma Sutra. This Adhikarana is Akasha Adhikarana. Or it is also called Dahara Adhikarana. In Brahma Sutra, it is Dahara Adhikarana. It is called as 1314 to 1321 in 8 sutras, elaborate discussions there. Dharadikarna. Antaha akashet bhavati, tad akashakam brahma eva, not outer space. Akashoi namaiti vakshati. It will be said in the last portion of this Upanishad itself, that which is called as space is Brahman. In this 8th chapter only, 14th part, 814.1 is the number. 814.1. Iti vakshat, that I said, it will be stated later. Akasha eva asharira, then why you are saying, why don't you say directly Brahman? Dharasvinantar, Brahma. Then directly Brahma. Why you use the word Akasha? He says, because Akasha eva asharira, sukshmattu saragatattu samanyaccha. If at all I had used directly the word Brahman, then you would have thought that Brahman is limited. So therefore, knowingly, an illustrative word is being used for Brahman here, Akasha. So you can get into the similarities of this Akasha into Brahman. And you can say, as this external space is how? Without a body. A shariratva, unembodied, sukshmatva, subtleness, sarvagatatvacha, all pervasiveness. These are the similarities. And by these similarities, You will have to take these qualities for meditation in Brahman. That is the main purpose of keeping the word over here, Akasha. Instead of keeping directly the word Brahman. Tasmin Akashakya, even in that internal smaller space, Yat Anta Madhya, that which is inside it, exists in the inside it, is called as space, Tasmin Akashakya. In that space, which is called by the word Akasha, Yadantaha, that which is existing inside it, Tadanveshtavyam, that has to be known. Tadvava, Tadevacha, that indeed only. Visheshena Jijnyasitavyam, iti Vijijnyasitavyam. That has to be sought for realization. How? Guruvashri Shravanadi Upaye Anvishya Sakshatkaraniyam Ityartha. You have to go up to Sakshatkara, not only to knowing it, especially knowing it. No. Up to Bhaskara says, Vijigyatam is Sakshatkaraniyam Ityartha. And how the process has been called direct realization? It is to be directly realized. Sakshatkaraniyam is direct realization of Brahman. How? By wishing to know it through or seeking the shelter or the help of a teacher. And through that teacher also, by adopting such means like Shravanadi Upayahi, Shravana Nidhyasana. Anvisha, having known, you have to realize, have direct experience of it, Sakshat Karaniyam Ityartha. This is the meaning of the last portion, Tadva Vajigyasana Vimiti. After that, Acharya was announced so in front of the disciples as a last instruction. Those disciples, if by chance they ask, then the teacher has to reply, otherwise keep quiet. Just like Virochana went away, even Brahmaji announced, without knowing you are going. But still Virochana went away. Brahmaji did not call Virochana. He did not, when Indra came back, he did not tell, come on, go and drink Virochana also. That was unfit. The unfit friends will not listen. Yeah, that's why Bhashya, the mantra is saying, Tam Ched Bruyuhu. Ched, very important word. Tam Ched Bruyur. Yadidam Asmin Brahmapure Dharam Pundrikam Veshva Dharasmanam Trakasha Kintadatta Vidyade Yadan Veshthavyam Yadvavajigyasitavyam Idi Sabruyat. Tanchet Brio, if those students in front of whom the teacher has announced, they ask them to that teacher, to him, to the team in front of that teacher, if at all they ask, how do they ask? They'll say the whole mantra, the same thing. In this city of the Supreme Reality, Brahman, that which is like a lotus and like it dwelling in the heart, in which you stated that a small space, Asmanantaraka, Dharavakasha, in which is a smaller space, in that you said there is something which has to be known. Kim tadatra vidyate, what is that existing over there? Atra, and in this heart, kim tat vidyate, what can exist over there? Nothing. There's such a small space, what can be there? Eh? Can you find an elephant in the hole of his noodle? Impossible. How can we say great Brahman is a small heart, small space? That's impossible. The Shishyas are putting this question to the teacher as if it's impossible. Kim tadrivide? Nakinchit itartha. Pashkal also will tell, nakinchit itartha. Yadan veshtavim, yadvavajigyatam iti. That which can be known, which has to be known, and which is indeed to be sought for realization, etc., etc. Sabruya. Then the teacher should reply as asked it in the next mantra, to remove all doubts and delusions in the student. They are thinking that the space is small space. In that small space, what can be there? Therefore, I have to say, no, as big as this space is, the vastness and the expanse of this space, same is the space therein also. Then they will get shocked. What is this? Itna bada akash in the heart, how it can be? That is how the jigyasa has to be produced in mandabuddhinam. Bhashyam. Tanchet. Eva muktavantam acharyam. To the teacher who had spoken thus. Chet means yadi, if at all. Bruhu, they say. Who? Antevasanas chodayayuhu. The students living with him, if they ask a question in this way. Katam? How? What would be the question? He says, Edam asundra pure parichinni antar daharam pundarikam veshma. That there is, in this city of Brahman, the Supreme Reality, which is limited, parichinne brahmapure asmin. How is this body? This body is the Brahmapura, the city of the Brahman, the Supreme Reality. And is parichinne. It is being limited by the adjunct called body itself. Inside this body, anta, dharam, pundarika, veshma. He has said there is a small lotus-like dwelling. Tatopyantaha, and further within it, there is still small alpatarayeva akasha. In that lotus-like dwelling, is further as mapundarika eva veshmani tavat kim syat. So, in that lotus-like dwelling, what can there be? Kim tat alpatarekhe? When nothing is possible in the heart itself, how can there be further in that smaller space? The heart itself is small. Inside that only nothing can be. And smaller than that is internal space. How can there something inside that also be? Impossible. Kim tato alpatrekhe yad bhavedityahu? They ask, what can there be which is further smaller? What can there exist in that small space of heart, which in the internal space of the heart, which is smaller than the heart? Which is smaller than the heart? Tato alpatare khe akashe yad bhavet kim ityahu. Dharo asminantra akasha. Kim tadatra vidite na kinchana vidite iti viprayaha. Bhashyakara does it clear now. In this small space, what is it that can exist over there? Kinta dutra vidyate, vidyate. That means to say, na kinchit vidyati viprayaha. The idea is that nothing can exist over there. Because even a plum, small, badar plum, badar plum, even that cannot go into the heart. So small space is there. Completely is mansam only, most heart. Space is very less inside over there. Even a balafaram cannot go into that space. And inside that space, there is something else you say. How can it be? Yadi nama badramatram kimapi vidyate, kim tasya anvashanena vidyasitenava, phalam vidyasitusya. If at all by chance, let us accept that something is there. How much big it can be? Not more bigger than a plum size. So what is the use of knowing such a thing? Yadi nama badra matram kim vidyate, even if something of the size of a plum, if I accept also that exists over there, even then, kintasya anveshanena vijigyasitena. Va phalam vijigyasitusya. What result will be attained by the knower? By knowing or realizing it, which is so small. That means we gain nothing of it. So useless to think about such a thing at all. Ato yat tatra anveshtavya vijigyasam va natena prayojanam iti uktavata. Therefore, to him who says that there is no need of knowing or realizing whatever exists over there, for to him uktavata, to that person who has said so, sa acharyo bruyat, then the teacher should say so. Iti shrutir vachanam. This is a statement of the Upanishad. What he has to say, that's being stated in the next mantra. Yavan vayam akashas, tavan neshvanta hrudaya akasha, ubhe asmin dyava prithviyantareva samahite, ubhav agnischa vayuscha, surya chandramasa vabhav, विद्युन नक्षत्राणि यच्च सिहास्ति यच्च नास्ति सर्वं तदस्मिन् समाहितमिति। यावान् वयम् आकाशः द स्पेस विन द हार्ट अंतर्हृदये आकाशः एष आकाशे अंतर्हृदये द स्पेस दैट विच इज विद इन द हार्ट इज यावान् अयम् आकाशः तावान् भवति इज एज वास्ट एज दिस स्पेस विच इज आउटसाइड उभयस्मिन् द्यावा पृथ्वी। शॉकिंग स्टेटमेंट। व्हाट टू से मोर ही सेड विद इन इट अस्मिन् माने विद इन दैट स्पेस इटसेल्फ इंडीड बोथ दिस हेवन एंड अर्थ आर एग्जिस्टेंसेस आर इंक्लूडेड इन दैट हार्ट हेवन एंड अर्थ एवरीथिंग ऑल द वर्ल्ड्स आर इन योर हार्ट ओनली। Can you believe it? No, that is a foolishness again. You can't believe it. Vishvam darpana drishyamana nagari tulyam nijantargatam pashyannatmani mayaya bahiriva udbhutam yatha nidraya yah sakshat kurude prabodha samaye svatmanam eva advayam tasmai shri gurumurtaye namaidam dakshinamurtaye। It is inside only, seen outside foolishly, because of ignorance, it seems to be outside. Nothing is outside. Whatever you think, that you see outside. This is Srishti, Drishtivada, no? Drishti, Srishtivada. Drishti, Srishtivada, Srishti, Drishtivada, everything is outside you. Nothing is inside. But actually speaking, everything inside, nothing is outside. And when you give up inside and outside division also, there is nothing either inside, nothing neither outside. And everything is nothing, that is you only. Ajatavada. So the steps. He wants to, up to here all, he has studied about Srishti Drishtivada only. Tattejo Srijata, Swakamaya Dandal Ventan, it's Srishti Drishtivada. And now here he says, oh, Drishti Srishtivada. But all you are seeing outside, everything is inside. And by our own ignorance, due to the ignorance, the mahima of ignorance is, the greatness is of that ignorance, that it shows that is within as out. Dhyava prativyantareva. Within it is included both heaven and earth. Abhavagnishya vayushya. As also both fire and water are included in that heart itself. Even the sun and moon are in the heart. But still you don't feel the heat. Ubhav, vidyun nakshatrani cha. Vidyut and nakshatra, the lightning and stars are also within you. The lightning don't create any danger to you. Because there are kalpitam eva. Yachya asya yasti, whatever this one has over here and whatever you don't have. All that, tad, asmin samayitam is included in it only. Shranuta, listen the statement you made. Listen to me, he says. Shranuta, listen. He says, the teacher answers to the students, listen. Tatriyadabhruti, the statement that you made with regard to that akasha, that space, which is pundrikanta khasya, alpatva tastham alpataram syaditi. What did you say? Anuvada. Reassumption of what the student has said. Pundarikanta khasya. That the space within the heart, the lotus, is small. Hence, tastham alpataram sya. Whatever exists there will be smaller than the heart. Is what you have said. Then what can be there? Nothing. You said so. Is it not? Tadasat. That's totally wrong. Why? It is wrong because nahi kham pundrika veshmagatam pundrika dalpataram matva vocha. Because when I said within that is a small space, dharo asmin nantrakasha iti yada vocham tad iti matva na vocham. When I said this statement, which statement? Dharo asmin nantrakasha. In this, there is a small space. By this statement, I don't mean, I don't want to say that what Naikam Pundarika Veshma Gatam. I did not mention, I did not mean to say that with the idea, I did not have the idea or intention of mind to say that the space which exists in the lotus-like dwelling is smaller than the lotus. This is not the meaning that I intended in the statement. Pundarika alpatramiti matva na avocham. You have to conjugate in this way. Yat taharo asmin antarakashati avocham tat pundarika vishamagatam pundarika alpatramiti matva nahi avocham iti. Then the student asks, Kintari, then what do you mean by that? What was your idea or intention behind the statement? Then what? Says, Pundarikam Alpam. The lotus is small, no doubt. Because that is a physical thing, heart was just thinking, which usually know, all people understand by that. But, Tad Anvidhai Tatstham Antakkaranam. The internal organ which corresponds to that and contained in it is, what is that? How is it? Pundarika Akasha Parichinnam, which is limited by this Antakarna, that Pundarika Akasha, the space of the lotus, in that Tasmin Vishuddhe. Samritakarnanam yoginam svachyavodake pratvimbarupam madarashivacha shuddhe svacham vijnanajyot sarupavabhasam tavan matram brahma upalapriti iti avocham. I want to say that there you will be realizing, experiencing, attaining Brahman itself. How? That's being stated now, you see. Even if it's limited by the space within the lotus, that internal organ, Tasmin Vishuddha, but when that internal orb is pure, which is an adjunct to that Brahman, sure, no doubt, is an adjunct to the Brahman, it is an Upadhi, adjunct means Upadhi, is an Upadhi, an adjunct to the Brahman, no doubt. That is small, no doubt even then. Lotus is small, heart, inside that, the space, by space and meaning, internal organ, the Antakarna, that is also smaller than the lotus, no doubt in that. But that which is being experienced by the pure internal organ within that lotus, as if it is within the internal organ, is that the internal organ is adjunct to Brahman. The upadhyaya vachinna, upadhyaya vishishta is Brahman. Therefore, I am saying it is inside that. But actually, it is not inside it. It is being experienced by it. This should be the meaning of it. Tasmin Vishuddhe, in that purified internal organ, of whom? Yoginam, of the yogis. How they are? Sahrita Karanaram, who have withdrawn their senses from the external objects, etc., etc., as before, by them, Brahman will be realized. Brahma Upalabhyate, the last word of the statement, Brahma Upalabhyate. How? If you ask, then it gives examples. Svachyava udake pratibimbarupam. Just like an image appearing in a clear water. Or adarshivacha shuddhe. Or a clean mirror, just as you see in your own reflection. Similarly, svacham, you'll be experienced Brahman, is not. How is that Brahman again? Svacham. Your heart is pure, and therefore you can see that pure, without any qualities, that non-qualified Brahman can be experienced there. The form of clear reflection of what? Vijnana Jyoti Surupavabhasam. The form of clear reflection of the light of knowledge. Vijnana Jyoti. Vijnana means knowledge. The Jyoti is the light of knowledge. How is that light of knowledge also? It's clean. Because the light of knowledge is not at present possessed or identified by any object of the world. Always what do you have? We have knowledge even now. But the adjuncts or objects are there. There is object, subject, subject and predicate. There is there always in our jnana. But how it is there now? At that time? So swacham. That's why the word is given swacham. Because the light of knowledge is there in every vritti. Whether there is object or not. Therefore, but we have to state those reflection of light of the knowledge which does not possess any object. Then only it is pure. Tavan matram. As though it is of that size only. As though it is of that size only. Tavan matram. Matrach pratyayar it is. After the tavachar, matrach pratyay is being used. As if it is of that size, you will be experienced the Brahman. Though Brahman is not of that size. To explain this thing with this intention, I had stated the statement Antakarnopadinimittam. Since there is the internal organ acting as a limiting adjunct to the Brahman, therefore I had to say this statement. Because there is only way a dull minded person, a dull intellectual person can grasp the thing. Because always his mind is objective. He can never become totally subjective. Then we have to give some object of meditation. The object of meditation first we take him into this body. See your own body first. Brahmapure. In this Brahmapura, now what should I see? Close your eyes and see your heart. And in that heart, look into your own mind and intellect. And our that mind and intellect should be devoid of objects. Upasangrata karnaihi karnevi karnevihi. Those who have given up all the objects. In that state only a yogi can experience this Brahman as a clear reflection of the light of knowledge. Svatastu. Because of the adjunct I told, smaller, smaller, smaller. But actually by itself, svata. Yavanvi prasiddha parimanato ayam akasho bhautika tavan yeshu antarhudaya akasho bhavati. By itself, however, the space within the heart regarding which I said one must know and realize. Yes, minan veshtavyam vijitatum iti chavachama. That is as vast as this physical or the material space which we are seeing outside. Yasmin Aveshta Vijatamiti Ochama, that Akasha, Hrde Akasha, how is it? Is it by itself, however, it is as vast as the space. By Parimanata, by its expanse, how it is? Akasho Bhautika. As vast as the expanse of this external, the physical, or materialistic, material, your space of the same size. Never say so. Not of the same size. That also will be now negated later. Just it is an example to make you realize the vastness only and the expanse only, but it's not the equal size of the text space. Because the space is also an effect of Brahma. And naturally, any effect is smaller than the cause. There's a Bhaskara says, Napi Akasha Tulli Parimanatva Prati Tavanityuchate. I have not said, moreover, the words here, Atavan, etc., as vast as have not been used in the sense to make you realize that's of the same size. Never think so.